Hello everybody, it's Dana Sullivan, the Stampin' Chick, here with another Make It Monday! How are you today, my friends? It is a fabulous Monday. This is February 1st. Holy mackerel, where did January go? Alright, today's project is a super fun and sweet one. I'm using the Friendly Flamingos Stamp and Die Bundle. The stamps are so sweet. The dies are super cute. So in the dies, you have this big outline die that cuts the stamped image. And then you have this little solid die that cuts cardstock and coordinates with these two wing panels. Now, from my experience here making this project, these two layer together to create the texture that you see on the wings. It's actually very, very cute. So let's get started, shall we? All right, what you're going to need, you'll need a piece of So Saffron cardstock. This one measures 4 1/4 by 8 3/8 inches. You'll need a piece of Misty Moonlight that measures 3 inches by 4 7/8 inches. You'll need a piece of Balmy Blue that measures 2 3/4 by 3 1/4. And then you'll need some scraps and layering circles dies. These are the third smallest of the scalloped and regular circle dies. This is in Flirty Flamingo. This is in Basic White. Of course, you can see I've already stamped it for the sake of time. And then you'll also want to cut one each of the flamingo and each of the two wing pieces because we'll layer those together as well. You'll also need some basic white scraps that we're going to stamp and die cut these beautiful floral pieces, the flower cluster, and then the grass leafy vine thing right here. All right, now I have done most all of the stamping already just to get us okay on time, but let's go back to the base pieces first. Now, this card is actually a lot of fun, and it's pretty easy to put together. So, this is what's called a step card or a step-up card. And you can see here that it has the two layers that kind of step up, hence the name. But the card also folds flat and is the size of a regular standard A2 card, so that way you can put it in an envelope and you can send it out, and excuse me, and the recipient will absolutely love it. So it's got a lot of little details here and it's just a lot of fun. So with your card base, this is the 4 1/4 by 8 3/8 inch piece. You're gonna start it off by doing some scoring. Now you're gonna score at 3/8 inch, 1 3/8 inch, 2 7/8 inch, and 3 7/8 inch. Now you don't necessarily have to worry about the measurements and everything, writing them down, because there'll be a link down in the description below where you can click over to my blog and it'll have all of the measurements written down there, okay? All right, now for this Misty Moonlight piece, we're going to score it at 3/8 inch and 1 3/8 inch, just like we did the first two score lines on the So Saffron piece. Okay, and then as you can imagine, the Balmy Blue is a layering piece for this section here. Okay, all right, so the first thing that we want to do once we have scored our card bases, that we want to burnish our lines. Okay, there's that one. And then the base. Now we're going to do just a little bit of stamping on the base. because the Friendly Flamingo bundle doesn't have a designer series paper that coordinates, and so I didn't use a designer series paper. I thought I would just stamp on cardstock. So what I want to do is bring in my Pierce mat, because we're using photopolymer stamps. And once you have folded, you've scored and folded and burnished all of your lines, I have gone ahead and put tear and tape on the 3/8 inch strips close to the fold. Now, you don't have to do that just yet, but I've already done it here. So once you've folded and burnished, you want to make sure that the piece that you're going to adhere to is the side that we're going to be stamping on, and that'll make sense here in just a second. So once you've burnished and scored your lines, go ahead and open it up, and we're going to do some stamping right here on the big section. Now, I'm going to be using So Saffron ink and that long, skinny, leafy stem, okay? And all I'm gonna do is tap, 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 of course, and I'm gonna just randomly stamp, and I'm gonna do a little double stamping. So you see that I've done one full color and one is stamped off, and I'm staggering the sizes. Now, it's okay to go over into this next section because you're not gonna see it anyways. It's gonna be covered up by the fold. So we'll just keep doing the tap, tap, tap and stagger our sizes. And we're basically creating our own designer series paper that will make a nice background for our flamingo. Okay, there we go. Last one, very nice. Okay, now then, if you haven't already, you're gonna put your tear and tape strip on the back side. So if this is the side we've stamped on, you're putting it on the opposite side. And then you can go ahead and pull off the adhesive backing. And now what I want you to do is, the first line is the 3/8 inch section, and the second line is the 1 3/8 inch section. I want you to fold it on the one after, which is the 2 7/8, so it'll be the third one from the end, or the second one from the back, okay? So we're gonna fold it right there. That leaves the one section that we may have stamped into. And then we're going to just tuck that adhesive strip and touch it down, okay? Now you'll take your Misty Moonlight piece and you'll put adhesive on that little 3/8 inch strip if you haven't already. Go ahead and pull off the backing. And we're going to line this edge up with just slightly off center of the base. So right about there. And then once you have that, you're gonna tuck that adhesive strip and stick it down. All right. Now then, you've got this piece that flaps up. You'll go ahead and put some tear and tape on the bottom edge of that. Pull the backing off. And stick it back down. All right, now when you pop open your card, you have your base. Isn't that neat? And I love the fact that this is a freestanding card. So any decoration that you put on here, the person can stand it up on their mantle and it's visible without any worries of it falling over, which is nice. Okay, now, and remember, when you fold it flat this way, that's a standard card base, so it'll fit perfectly in your envelope. All right, now what we want to do is we're going to go ahead and stamp on the balmy blue section using Misty Moonlight ink, and the little water ripple. Okay, so let me just take this out. Tap, 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 not smush, smush, smush. Oops, grab my pin. Not my pin, my pierce mat. There we go. And you want this to be near the bottom and to the right. So just like that. And that's all of the stamping that we're gonna do. Everything else has already been done. And we'll attach this piece to the front of our card. Okay. Very good. All right, now for that flamingo. We've die cut each of the three pieces, and you'll notice that one of the wing pieces has some ripples on it, which are to look like the feathers, and then the other piece is more solid. So what I want you to do is take the piece that has the ripples on it and use liquid glue. And we're just going to put a little bit of glue over the whole back. Now, don't get carried away because a little dab will do ya. And when we lay these together, you'll notice that the solid one is a little bit wider than the other one that has the embossing on it. However, you can line up the edges. So you'll see here, I'm just lining up right there and right here, okay? So just about like that. And then I'm gonna take a large Stampin' Dimensional and a small Stampin' Dimensional, and I'm gonna layer them onto my flamingo. Just like that. Isn't that cute? I just love him. All right, now we're going to use liquid glue. We're going to attach our flamingo in the little ripple of water there. So you want to put some glue on the main part of his body and on his legs, but leave it off of his head and tail so that he can hang over the edge just a little bit. Go. Put our little friend right there. Perfect. All right. Now the next thing that we're going to do is start layering all of this stuff together. So I've already stamped "Hoping your day is amazing as you are," and I did that in the Misty Moonlight ink. So I'll take my liquid glue and I'm just gonna attach it to the Flirty Flamingo layer, just like so. Okay, and then I'm gonna take the stem that I've stamped in old olive ink and die cut out with the dies. I'm gonna put a little bit of glue just on the bottom part of it. So the bottom two leaves and the little stem there. And I'm gonna put this right at the edge of where the Misty Moonlight piece is. So something to that effect. Now this part is gonna be open, and that's so that it can be dimensional when it pops up. So you see that? All right, and then I have stamped in old olive ink and die cut this piece out, and then I used So Saffron and Calypso Coral Stampin' Blends to color in the flowers, and we'll pop this piece up with Stampin' Dimensionals. So let me grab my dimensionals here, and I just need three pieces, I think. All right. And then I'm gonna layer this right here on the edge. I wanna make sure that it's not going over the bottom edge here. It can hang over the edge this way a little bit, but you don't want it to be past the bottom edge. So I want it to be something like that. And then I'm gonna put dimensionals only on the top and the bottom here. So since I know this side is gonna hang over, I'm gonna put my finger there in the way, flip it over, put my dimensionals right there. And then I can layer this piece on just like so. All right, the last thing that we have to do is to make our bow. And let me just set this out of the way here right quick. I'm using the Flowers for Everything blue and white braided twine. I really like it, and it's got a nice little hint of silver metallic thread in it. Makes it just the right amount of pop for this card, doesn't it? All right, so I'm doing a double looped bow, and I'll tell you the easiest way to do this is just to fold your twine in half. And I'm going to say approximately 10 inches. Let me see. You see how close to right I am? Okay, that's 9 inches. So fold it in half approximately to 9 inches. We're probably gonna need 10 though, watch. Okay, maybe we won't. All right, and then all I'm gonna do is just tie both strands together into a standard little bow. Now the only thing is you wanna make sure that you're catching both sets of loops. So you wanna make sure that as you're doing it, you're looking at both sets of loops in order to get it to tie properly. Okay, yeah, that'll work. I could have used 10 inches. All right. That loop needs to go back a little bit. Fiddle with it just ever so slightly and then let it go. There we go. All right, now I'm gonna use a glue dot to attach this because honestly, that is the easiest way to attach ribbons and bows to your projects. Okay, and then we're just gonna put this right here near the bottom, just like so. And then we are done. All right, so now to get it to stand up properly, you may want to fold it down in the way that you're going to pack it in the envelope, and then fold it up so that way you're really giving those lines a good even balance. And then when it stands up, there we go, it'll stand up all by itself. So absolutely perfect, and it'll sit well, it looks nice, it's absolutely beautiful. And then of course you can write any kind of a sentiment that you'd like on the back side of your card, so it's just fabulous. All right, friends, these products are in the spring mini catalog, and you can get them, especially right now during Sailabration, for every $50 that you purchase, you can get a free item from the Sailabration catalog. So the spring catalog has all kinds of amazing things in it. There's the Friendly Flamingo bundle. It's a really nice and inexpensive bundle. And then the Sailabration items are all in this little booklet here. So if you aren't a demonstrator and don't already have a spring catalog, please let me know and I will make sure to get the catalog and Sailabration brochure to you so that you can earn some free stuff. February is the last month for Sailabration, so you don't want to wait too long to get these amazing products and get some free stuff. All right, friends, you can visit my website, thestampinchick.com, and there will be a link down in the description for today's blog post. And my website to purchase any of the supplies are danasullivan.stampinup.net. thank you all so much for watching and spending some time with me today. If you're not already subscribed to my channel, don't forget to click the subscribe button so that you don't miss any future projects. And until next time, my friends, I'll see you later. Bye for now.